Hi, today in this video we'll talk about Kelly's coefficient of skewness. Now basically what happens in Kelly coefficient of skewness is this is just another measure as Carl Pearson's is Boley's coefficient of skewness. Although this Kelly's coefficient of skewness is very rarely used and is only for theoretical purpose, but still let's try to understand it, what exactly is Kelly's coefficient of skewness, but because there are some cases where we can use them, like there are certain cases where we don't have quartiles or median mode, but we have some deciles and percentiles. So in those cases, we can use them, right? So we'll straight away go towards the formulas where the Kelly has suggested the formula based upon the 10th and the 90th percentile, right? Or the first or the 9th deciles. This how to find these percent and deciles we have already discussed in one of our previous videos, so you can always look up to them. So Kelly has simply stated that Kelly's coefficient of skewness is simply equal to 9th percentile of P90 plus 10th percentile of P10 minus 2 into median, or I can also talk this as P50. P50 is same as the median. Upon P90 minus P10, which is again similar to, we already know ki jo P90 is, that is equal to D9. So this can also be written as like this, minus 2 median upon D9 minus P1. We can use any of the formula. So here P90 simply means 90th percentile, and D9 means 9th decile. So it can be anything and corresponding things, so we can always use them. Now it's simple that whenever we'll get that SK, Kelly's coefficient of skewness is greater than 0, then this means positively skewed. And if Kelly's coefficient is less than 0, then that simply means negatively skewed. And this is quite similar as Carl Pearson's Boley's coefficient of skewness, where if the sign is positive, it's positively skewed, and if the sign is negative, then it's negatively skewed. So now let's discuss an example of how to compute them. We are given a data, and now we are asked to calculate Kelly's coefficient of skewness, right? So first of all, let's just write down the formula. Our formula is simply, we'll use this percentiles formula, which is the main formula. SKK is equal to P90 plus P10 minus 2 median upon P90 minus P10. Now in order to compute all this, first of all, what do we need is, we need P10. P90 and median, right? So first of all, let's find P10. Formula for P10. So for P10, before that, in order to find this P10, first of all, we need to find what is 10N by 100, right? 10N by 100, for that, what do we need? We need N, right? That is sum of the number of students. When we'll sum them up, we'll get 100, right? So we need to find, we know 10n by 100 is equal to 10. So we need, now we need to find the CF that is just greater than or equal to 10, right? So in order to find that, we need our cumulative frequencies. So this cumulative frequency is simply 8 plus 12, 20. 20 plus 20, 40. 40 plus 30, 70. 70 plus 15, 85, plus 10, 95, plus 5 is 100, right? So now we need to find that for P10, we need to find that where the CF is equal to 10 or just greater than 10. Over here it's 8, which is less than 10, 20, which is just greater than 10. So what can I say? I can simply say that in class interval 10 to 20, my P10 lies. My P10 lies in this class interval. Now simply we know that P10 is equal to lower limit plus 10n by 100 minus cumulative frequency upon f into h, right? This is something we have already discussed in our previous video, where I'm just stating them, where L is equal to lower limit of P10 class interval. N we already know, right? F is equal to frequency of P10 class interval, right? And C is equal to cumulative frequency of class interval just before P10. P10 class interval, right? So now we already have this. So I'll simply put in the values for this. What is my P10 then? So my P10 is equal to, what is the lower limit? Lower limit is 10. Plus 10n by 100, you already computed this as 10 minus c of the previous class interval. Matlab, yahan se 8. And then what is f? F over here is 12 into 10. This is simply 10 plus 1.67, which is 11.67. So now we will also find median over here. So median. For median, what do we exactly need? We need is n by 2. N by 2 over here is 50. Now we need to check the CF, that is just greater than or equal to 50. So that class interval for which the CF is just greater than or equal to 50, that is this 30 which is to 40. 30 by 40 is our median class interval. Right? So using this, we know simply our median is equal to lower limit plus n by 2 minus c upon f into h. Putting in the values, lower limit is obviously for 30 is 2, 40 is 30. Plus n by 2 is already 50 minus 40 upon 30 into 10. And that is simply 33.33. Right? So now what else do we need? Now we need is P90. So for this P90, first of all, what do we need? We need to find 90n by 100. We already know that. So 90n by 100 is 90 into 100 by 100. That is equal to 90. So now, since this is 90, we need to find that CF in this column that is just greater than or equal to 90. So 85 is less, so 95. So this 50, 60 is our P90 class interval 50 to 60. So now again, by doing this, now we know that P90 is simply equal to L plus 90N by 100 minus c upon f into h. So fetching in the values, lower limit is obviously this 50 plus 90n by 100 from here, this 90. Now this 90 minus cumulative frequency of the previous class interval, that is this 85. And what is my frequency of current class interval? That is 10. And what is the height? Is again 10. That is 50 to 60 has a width of 10. So when we solve this, this is simply 50 plus 5, which is equal to 55. Now we have all the values. So since we have all the values, I can say that Kelly's coefficient of skewness is simply equal to P90 plus P10 minus 2 median upon P90 minus P10. This was our formula. So now putting in the values, P90 is 55 plus 11.67, I've already noted down the values from the previous slide, minus 2 into 33.33 upon 55 minus 11.67, right? So this is simply 0.01 upon 55 minus, we can simply solve this also. 55 minus 11.67 is simply 43.33, which is equal to 0.000. So by seeing this, we can say that more or less there's a very little skewness, or it's more a symmetric data, but it's not a perfectly symmetric data, right? So there's some skewness that lies in a given distribution, right? So this is how we compute Kelly's coefficient of skewness, although this is very rarely used in statistics and it's not a much reliable figure because it is more based upon our extreme figures and the most middle figures. We are not considering the middle data. That is the data between P90 and P50 and again P50 and P10. I hope you like this video. Do subscribe this channel for more videos. Thank you.